And our third main topic today gets submitted to us by Joaoedits, who writes, "Hey, John, great news. Deadline reported that a TED TV series is in the works." And we're not talking about TED as in the TED Talks, but TED as in the talking teddy bear. "TED TV series is in the works at Peacock with Seth MacFarlane in talks to reprise his role. He does the voice of Ted. For now, there are no plans for the films Mark Wahlberg and Mila Kunis to appear in the series, which is expected to be a prequel to the 2012 movie. I love Ted. This is fantastic. What are your thoughts?" All right, thanks for sending that in. And yeah, listen, when it comes to just the Ted movies are not, you know, Quentin Tarantino. They're not Shakespeare. But when it comes to just delivering laughs, for me, they don't get much better than Ted. I mean, Ted is really great at just making you laugh. Is it the greatest stories? No. Is it the greatest dialogue? No. It just makes you laugh, and they're great. And even though I didn't think the second one was quite as good as the first one, it had some of the biggest laughs I've ever had in movie theaters. So I've always liked it. Now, Peacock, which is still an absolutely ridiculous name for a streaming service, but you know, I've been saying a lot over the last couple of months, they've really been impressing me. I find myself using the Peacock app a lot more than I ever thought that I would, and they continue to make moves. And of course, in the recent weeks, Rob and I have talked about some stories about some moves they've been making. But now, they're looking about bringing a Ted series. Okay, so this comes to us from the folks over at the Movie Web who write, "Ted is heading to the small screen. Seth MacFarlane, who wrote and directed both Ted movies, in addition to voicing the vulgar teddy bear, is finalizing a deal with NBC Universal's Peacock for a live-action prequel TV series. The 10-episode straight-to-series order would bring back MacFarlane in a similar capacity by heading the creative direction and providing the unique voice of the animated character." And that last part, that MacFarlane is in a similar capacity by heading the creative direction and providing the unique voice of the animated character, to me, that's kind of the key thing here. Because if they were to say, doing a TED TV series, interested, and if they said, and Seth MacFarlane will be one of the producers, which means nothing, then I'd probably lose a lot of my interest. There is no TED without Ted MacFarlane running it. Seth MacFarlane running it. And if they're saying that he's going to be run the whole creative on it and still do the voice, yeah, I mean, it would be cool if it did have Mila Kunis and Mark Wahlberg, but it doesn't need to. All you need is Ted. So I'm going to guess it's Ted when Mark Wahlberg's character was a lot younger and all the different adventures they would have. And again, look, much like the Ted movies, guys, I'm not expecting Shakespeare. I'm not expecting, you know, world-renowned writing. All I'm looking for is some laughs. That's what the movies gave me. And if the TV series can give me the same, I, for one, will be pretty happy. Rob, you hear that they're moving ahead over there at Peacock with a Ted TV prequel. Good idea, bad idea? Are you looking forward to it? What do you think about this?
Well, this is going to seem weird, but I loved the first Ted movie, but I hated the second Ted movie.
You're not the only one. And yeah.
I thought that they completely missed the boat. The first Ted movie had a certain, let's call it, verisimilitude. Like, in the world, Ted, I could believe that Ted was somehow real. But because the way they played the story, and then by the Ted 2, it just became absurd, and I didn't buy it anymore. So I'm really hoping that Seth MacFarlane, during this series, brings it more back to the way the first movie sort of worked, that, okay, Ted exists in the world, but it's still the real world that we exist in. Like, nobody's taking a boat out to the middle of the ocean and dropping off a laptop. You're doing weird things that are more from an animated series than live action. So I'm hoping that it's good, because, as I said, I really enjoyed the first Ted. I thought it was a really great comedy. So I would definitely pull for something like that. I just hope that they take it in the right direction.
Dennis, you hear that they're going to do another Ted. This time it's going to be a series on Peacock. I mean, you got Seth MacFarlane involved. What are your thoughts on this? Good idea, bad idea? How do you see it?
Yeah, it's interesting, because me, as someone who doesn't really watch or kind of the main things that Seth MacFarlane is known for, like Family Guy and American Dad, I wasn't really like you know, super hyped for the Ted movie, the first one, and, you know, I enjoyed it. You know, I didn't love it, but I enjoyed it a lot more than I thought. And to tell you where my thoughts or my kind of idea of Ted, I completely forgot that there was a second movie until you just mentioned it like a few moments ago. I was like, oh, there was a Ted 2? And I know I saw it. It just, you know, that whole thing blended together. So as far as a TV series, I particularly don't need to watch it. But if someone else, if a lot of people are buzzing about it and say, hey, it's really, really good, I'll probably go check it out. But yeah, it's going to take place, you know, either when Mark Wahlberg's character is a teenager or something like when, you know, they mentioned in the beginning of the first Ted that when Ted becomes like a celebrity at first, right, and he goes around and goes on all the different talk shows and all that stuff. So maybe it covers that part. But yeah, I mean, it's expected. They're not going to spend the money on Mark Wahlberg and Mila Kunis and all that stuff for a prequel TV series on Peacock, which I think Peacock is free, isn't it? Like it's the only streaming service that is free.
They do something interesting. They have what HBO Max is now trying. They have multiple tiers. So they have a free tier, which doesn't give you everything, but it gives you most of what they have with commercials. Then they have the next tier up, which is like $5 a month, where you get almost everything. And then they have another tier up where you get absolutely everything and no ads or something along those lines. So they have, because HBO Max is introducing that now. Yeah. HBO Max now has a tier where you can pay $5 less, so like 10 bucks a month with some ads, which, you know, Rob and I, you talked about, just $5 off to get ads isn't enough of an incentive, but still, it is neat that Peacock is trying that that kind of approach. And if people are going to tune in to watch, Ted, question is for you guys. What do you think about this? Seth MacFarlane's doing, listen, I'm not going to lie to you. I never would have thought that they would do something like this, but I kind of like the idea. I'll at least be interested in checking out and see how it goes. How do you guys feel about it? Jump down into the comment section below and let us know your thoughts.